All right, so we're gonna try to take this pump apart. It's a pain in the butt to get the electric loose, so I'm just gonna leave it on there, I guess. Must have one of the bearings must have seized up. Got some little funny washer that I dropped on the ground. Some funny washer, lock washer, stainless steel screw, and the bag it goes. Let's see if we can get. All right, there's your bearing set up. Then your wobbler plate comes off. Don't look any more than normal use on that. Try to keep them in order. Of course I did. Let's see, cut. Like that. Concave plate towards the bearing. The other concave plate towards the bearing. And then, another piece doesn't seem to be coating off yet, but that's it. Just slides on there. Alright, we got one sealed bearing in the front here. I don't know if you can see it or not. One sealed bearing. Sorry about the electrical wiring, but it is what it is and was what it was. Because it's in the road. It's in the road. And what's next? What's next? What's next? Still can't turn it, so next get the four screws on the front one and then we'll separate that. Then we can see about the back. Oh, that front was a 3/16, huh? I thought I brought the metric ones out. Alright. Let's see. And the side ones are, I don't know. This is 4H. 4H. Hey, 4H. Trying to keep my earth wrench clear from this grease, but it ain't working. Because there's a ton of it here. Everything's getting all greasy and oily and yeah. Need an extension. Working way too hard. That was a long time, wasn't it? Which one do you think is bad? The front or back or both? Front, back, or both? Probably. This one got three screws on it. I don't think it was too old. Still keep hearing noise over there, but I don't see a squirrel in the tree. Alrighty, about ready to split this thing. Maybe. Clean it up. Everything's greasy and nothing wants them apart. Alright. I'll have to get the BFH. What's that? BFH. Everything's greasy and nothing wants them apart. Alright. I'll have to get the BFH. What's that? BFH. Alright, so after beating the crap out of it, at least I feel it beat the crap out of it, finally got this out with brass. So this one here in the front seems to be okay. Got rust all over it, so it's leaking. Leaking water in there somewhere or other. And it's kind of rusty in there. You can see it. Maybe that's what's holding it up, the rust. Yep. And let's see. Okay, the back bearing, which you can't see, is free. It's not locked up. Not freed, it's free. So, looks like to me that, water's got in here from the front. In the front. And did this damage. Rust. And that's what locked her up. So. Got some rust around there too. So what I gotta do. Really hard to tell without cleaning it up and putting it back together, cleaning all the rust out, and that bearing there, and then there's some kind of funny seal behind it. I can see a seal behind it, behind that bearing. I don't even know if I can get the seal or not. Can't. It's hard to show you. Show my five viewers. Right there's a seal right here. That doesn't seem to be tore up, but it's a lot of water mildew right there where water's been seeping in on them. So I don't even know where I start. I can clean this up and put it back together. I know it's going to work until that pump seal on the front leaks. And then What am I doing? There's no drain in the bottom to drain the water out of it. So it probably just fills up. Fills up. Shouldn't there be a drain on the bottom? I don't think there should be a drain in the bottom, but I can clean that out in there. That's what I'm gonna do. Clean her up. Alright, the impeller's all bent together. Right there, the four screws are in. Pressure sensors on, fans on the back. Alright, so now we gotta put it in our housing and hook everything up. Alright, so we spent a lot of time polishing. I don't have my lathe going yet, so we just use the grinder and I don't know. No rust. So, let's see. I know it's kind of rusty in here. I really don't know how to get that rust out of there. Rust remover? Let's see. Looks like to me it'll be okay. And the bearing seems good. Now I'm gonna try to find out if I can look up this unit and see if there's a seal available for it. What seal? And I don't know about the bearing. I don't know what there is to a seal in there. Doesn't look like much. It's the only way the water can get in there. Only way water can get in. Alright, so yeah, we're gonna try to clean up our mess here. And see if I can get the model number of that unit and see if it's available. Alright, the impeller's all bent together. Right there, the four screws are in. Pressure sensors on, fans on the back. Alright, so now we gotta put it in our housing and hook everything up. Alright, it's running now. It's spraying. Of course, you gotta remember, this is only 1500 psi, 1700 psi. Got a leak, I know that. It's common down there. They always leak down there.